Holy Alleluia. For the Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us pray. O God, who through the resurrection of thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, didst vouchsafe to give joy to the whole world, grant, we beseech thee, that through his mother, the Virgin Mary, we may obtain the joys of everlasting life. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Gloria in altare Dei, Dei glorificabili in tutto. Quelli che benedice il cielo e cosa mai leggente non santa, per nomine non quando lo sono. Amen. Quei tu sei lo scuoti pulma, il cuore del Cristo, il cuore Cristo sincero, con ufficio e medicus. E me demu già tu veritate in tu, misi che tu sei non ti produzza, non ti morti santi tua, tua, ma ti dava d'altro la tua. E in tua in altare Dei, Gloria Patri Filio e Spiritus Sancto, sicut erat in principio e nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In gloria volontari Dei, ed in beatifica in virtutum meum, aut domi nos mille benedicamus in privilegio cielo per terra. Confitio Dei in potenti via, la Maria Sanctis, in via, 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 in
via, in via, in via, in via,
in via, in via, in via, in via, in
via, in via, in via, in via, in via,
in via, in via, in via, in via, in
via, in via, in via, in via, in via,
in via, in via, in via, in via, in
via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in
via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, in via, popoli sanitati dalle e glorie osservate mari e sempre vicini senza cessione, la presenza liberale giustizia ed eterna per l'edizia. Ecclesia, tu e Paese, lo stavo e pregio, sto capo, sa vite, un distrutto e satisfazzi, così di voi, come sono vestis, sei pure che vi serve, deve cadere. Perdomino, nostro, mi esu, Cristo, divino, tu, che te non vive una regna, anche nell'etate, Spirito Santo, Deus, per la mia secula, seculor, Lex epistole viazzi Jacobi Apostoli. Carissimi, esto te factores verbi et non auditores tantum, falantes vos petitios. Quia si quis auditores verbi et non factor, e comparabitur vire considerabis voltum notat nativitatis sui in speculo. Considerabit enem se et ambiet in statum obitus est, qualis fuerit. Qui autem respectedit in legium effectum nativitatis, et per seret in ea non auditorum viviosus factus, sed facu omens, et beatus in facu suo erit. Si quis autem putans er religiosum esse, non lo refrenans linguam sua, sed seducens consumi, cuius vana est Livio. Livio mundre immaculata acuderum et patrem hec est. Visitare pupilus et viduas in jubilatione eonum, et immaculatum se costile a hoc seculo.
Deo gratias.
Alleluia, alleluia. Surrexit Christus et iluxit nobis, quos redemit sanguine suo, alleluia. Exivia patri et bene mundum, iterum delenco mundum, et vatu et patrem, alleluia. Suabiscum,
et cum spirito tuo,
sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Iohannem,
gloria tibi Domine,
in illo tempore redixit Iesus discipulis suis, amen, amen, dico vobis, sicui petendietis patrem in nomine meo, dabit vobis, usque modo non petistis quidquam in nomine meo, petite ad ecipietis, ut gaudium festum sic pleum, ecum proverbiis locutus sum vobis, venit hora, cum iam non in proverbiis loqua vobis, se palam de patre non siamo vobis. In illo die in nomine meo petetis, et non dico vobis, que ego rogabo patrem de vobis. Ipse enim pater amat vos, quia vos me amastis et credistis, quia ego ad Deo exivi. Exivi a patre veni mundum, iterum linco mundum et vado et patrem. Dicum de discipuli eus, eci non palam loque erise proverbium nullum dicis. Non scimus qui escis omnia, et non opus est tibi, ut quis te interroget in hoc credius, quia Deo existi. Laus tibi Christi. On this, the fifth Sunday post Pascha, the epistle is taken from the letter of St. James. Beloved, you must be honest with yourselves. You are to live by the word, not content merely to listen to it. One who listens to the word without living by it is like a man who sees in a mirror the face he was born with. He looks at himself, and away he goes, never giving another thought to the man he saw there. Whereas one who gazes into that perfect law, which is the law of freedom, and dwells on the sight of it, does not forget its message. He finds something to do and does it, and his doing of it wins him a blessing. If anyone deludes himself by thinking he is serving God when he has not learned to control his tongue, the service he gives is vain. If he is to offer service pure and unblemished in the sight of God, who is our Father, he must take care of orphans and widows in their need and keep himself untainted by the world. And the Holy Gospel today is a continuation of that according to St. John. At this time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Believe me, you have only to make any request of the Father in my name, and he will grant it to you. Until now, you have not been making any requests in my name. Make them, and they will be granted, to bring you gladness in full measure. I have been telling you this in parables. Now comes the hour when I will talk to you in parables no longer, but tell you openly about the Father. At the time I speak of, you will make your requests in my name, and there is no need for me to tell you that I will ask the Father to grant them to you, because the Father himself is your friend, since you have become my friends, and have learned to believe that I came from God. It was from the Father I came out when I entered the world, and now I am leaving the world and going on my way to the Father. Hereupon his disciples said to him, Why, now thou art speaking openly enough, this is no parable thou art uttering. Now we can be sure that thou knowest all things, not needing to wait till thou art asked. This gives us faith that thou wast sent by God. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass, as we said, on this, the fifth Sunday after Easter. From tomorrow, of course, is Rogationtide, leading up to Ascension Day on Thursday, which, of course, is a holy day of obligation. It's appropriate, then, that the last words of the Gospel today, though not our Lord's words, but those of his apostles, are these. Now we can be sure that thou knowest all things, not needing to wait till thou art asked. This gives us faith that thou wast sent by God. Because Rogationtide is all about prayer, it's all about asking God. Initially, of course, asking God in agricultural settings for his blessing, blessing upon the fields in advance of a bounteous harvest from his providence. We ourselves, of course, have many things that we might ask God for. Note that this, in the Gospel, our Lord says to the apostles, he invites them to ask in his name. It's interesting that our Lord himself never quite says that he is God. Have you noticed that he always kind of says it in an oblique way? So, for example, when he says, I am the bread of life, when he says the seven I am sayings in St. John's Gospel, he never says, I am God. But he says, I am this, that, and everything else. And he uses the phrase, I am. I am, of course, being a peculiar phrase to God, as we read in the Old Testament. And refers to himself invariably as the Son of God or the Son of Man. But yet it was blasphemy that he was charged with by the priests and the Pharisees. It was for blasphemy that he was condemned to death. And that's because although his words are not explicit, they are, of course, implicit. Asking someone to pray in your name, so in other words, not necessarily to address God directly, but to pray in Jesus' name. And elsewhere, of course, it is in the power of Jesus' name that the apostles and disciples and others cast out demons, performed exorcisms and healings. Ask and it shall be given to you, seek and ye shall find. Ask in my name, and I will ask the Father to grant it to you. How often, perhaps, my brothers and sisters, do we pray with expectation? We've touched on this many times before. St. John of Kronstadt, of course, you may remember, because I always quote him about this, suggested that God must get very frustrated with those who ask without expectation of receiving. And yet our Lord, of course, when he taught us to pray, when the disciples asked him to teach them how to pray, he gave the words of the Paternoster, of the Our Father. He suggests that we pray, Thy will be
in our prayers, we ought to ask for those things that we desire, for those things that we have need of. We ought to pray that for others. We ought to pray for the wealth and health and well-being of others. And we ought to pray for our own, for our friends, for our family. We can ask on their behalf whatever their needs are. But always we should ask that His will, God's will, be done. We should pray, if it is thy will, hear my request. If it be thy will, grant these requests. We might also always pray too for the grace to be able to accept what may be His will. It is often said of those who become frustrated by prayer that God does not always answer in our own time, or within the time frame that we would perhaps prefer. It's often been my experience. However, He does answer. He does reply. And perhaps what's more difficult about prayer, that people find difficult about prayer, is not necessarily about the asking. People are all too willing and too happy to ask, but it is in the receiving. It is in the receiving that grace is particularly necessary on our part. The grace to be patient. The grace of discernment. Being able to recognize when prayers have been answered. The grace to remember to offer prayer of thanksgiving when we've recognized the answer has been given. As we've said before, prayer is a dialogue. It's a two-way conversation. And to pray means a spiritual conversation. I may ask of your prayers here. I may ask of you in person. I may ask them of you online. I may ask them over the telephone. And when I ask, I will be conversing with you. Be having a conversation, a dialogue. And prayer as spiritual conversation is no different to that. So that when we ask for the saints of their intercession, we are conversing with them, just as you and I converse with each other here on earth. The communion of saints means, of course, that though they are the church in heaven, the church triumphant, and though we cannot see them, and though we cannot hear them, and though we cannot touch them, yet we can feel them, yet we can converse with them. Asking the saints to pray for us or to pray with us is no different to asking each other to pray for one another. Indeed, it's very similar to me asking you now to pray for me. You who are watching, I can't hear your response, can't see your response, but I may perceive your response. But I ask in faith, I trust in the asking. When we ask God, when we pray to God, we are conversing with Him. Of course, as I've said, the trouble is, of course, God is timeless. So His response is not always as immediate as we'd like. But nonetheless, it will be forthcoming. And sometimes we need the grace to accept a negative response. Not always get what we ask for if it doesn't or is not His will for us or for someone else. That's often a very difficult part of prayer for people to accept. Oh, well, I prayed for their healing. I prayed for their wealth. I prayed for their friendship. But the answer wasn't the one I wanted. But that's because sometimes it isn't in God's will for us. Often in vocational discernment, this can manifest itself. This is often the case. Person can feel that they are called to the sacred ministry or to the religious life, and in discerning, in prayer, may come to the conclusion either of themselves or from or through others that actually they aren't being called, or at least not for that particular task or ministry. Sometimes the grace of prayer is simply to accept God's will, which should prompt us to think again about what His will might be. So that if I pray for discernment in vocation, and I thought it was A, and that turns out to be negative, then I ought to pray again to find out what is it that I'm being called to. But discerning the response, discerning His answer, is as important as the asking. And in order often for us to be able to discern His answer requires us sitting quietly is perhaps the most difficult part of prayer. It's so easy, especially in our busy lives, to sit down for 5 minutes and either fall asleep or have our heads so full of thoughts. The quietening the mind can be difficult. Father Anthony Lazarus in Egypt says about finding silence or interior silence. He's the last, we might say, of the cave dwellers. He there in Egypt, near St. Anthony's monastery, near the father of the desert fathers, is in the mountains living a eremetical life of solitude and silence. But he says he needs that because his head sometimes can be so full of things that he might as well be standing in the middle of New York Times Square. And it's true that sometimes when we sit still, our head can be as busy and buzzing as if we were still in the office, or we were still in the heart of the family, or we were still socializing at party with friends. So developing a quiet mind, developing a stillness, developing a sense of peace and quietude is something we must all strive for. It does not come easily. But in doing so, we would of course be following after no less a master than our Lord himself, whom you will remember in the Gospel of various times. It is said, took himself off to be alone, to be quiet, to be still, to be with his Father. So in like fashion, my brothers and sisters, as easy as it is to ask, and as much as we ought to ask with expectation of an answer, let us also strive to find the ability to discern a response, to allow a response to be revealed to us. James, in his epistle today, reminds us that for all our praying and everything else, and all our external signs and displays of religion, are only vain religiosity. If the correct motivation of the heart isn't there behind it. The same is true of our prayers. If we do not pray expecting an answer, if we do not pray to know God's will, if we do not allow God's will to be made blessings out of his providence toward us. Prayers against famine, prayers against disease, prayers against trials and tribulations. Let us ask with expectation. Let us receive with grace and quietude, that we may know his will and respond to his will and live in love and in union with him, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum Deum, Pater omnipotentem, factorum caeli et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum, Filium Dei unigenitum, et ex patrem autem ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo, lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, genitum et patrem consubstantialem patrem, ego omnia facta sunt, qui propter nos habemus et propter nostrum salutem, descendit de caelis, et ita natus est de Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homus factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis Pontio Pilato passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit esse die, secundum scripturas, et descendit in caelum sedere dextram patris, et iterum venturus est cum gloria unitari vivos et mortuos, cuius regni non erit finis, et in spiritum sanctum dominum et vivificantem, qui ex patri procedi, qui cum patri et filio semel adorator et glorificator, qui locutus est per profetas, et una sancta catholica et apostolica ecclesia, confitia unum baptisma in remissione peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum et vita venturi seculi. Amen.
In Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo.
Alleluia. Benedicite gentes Dominum Deum nostrum, et abaudite vocem laudis eius, qui posuit animam meam et vitam, et non dedit come vedi pedes meus. Benedictus Dominus, qui non amovit deprecationem meam, et misericordiam suam a me. Alleluia.
Thank you.
Spirito tuo,
sosum corda,
habemus et Domino,
gracias ad amus Domino Deo nostro,
dignum et justum est,
vere dignum et justum est ebon et salutare, te quidem Domini omni tempore, se in appetissimum die, gloriosus felicare, cum pasca nostra vivoratus est Christus, ipse en venus es agnus quae absturis batatum, qui mortem nostrem oriente distruxit, et vita resurgendo repararum, et Deo cum angelis ed arcangelis cum tronis et dominationi plus cumque omnium iis celestis exegetus in gloriae tuae tantum sine fili di celibus.
Sanctus.
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 Dominus Deus sabaoth, plenis sub celi et terra gloria tua. Hosanna in excelsis.
Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini.
Hosanna
I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Thank you.
desiderarle quelle sunt e desiderate decidere. Per Dominum nostrum Jesum Christum finum tu, e tenum vive da regno ad unità di Spiritu Sancti Deus, per omnia sicula siculum.
Amen.
Ora de plus. Sum sis Domine salutis nostri subsidis, data esmus beate margens et virginis, patrucinis non subique pro te, in cui generazione eutrocinimus mestas. Caesus Domine Deus nostri, ut quas divine tribuis participatione cadere, cum manis al sinus acceri periculis. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tecum vive da regni ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo,
ite missa est,
Deo gratias.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum, et sum nomen usque in saecula, ut Domini nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci celum et terram, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo,
initium sancti evangelii secundum Ioannem,
gloria a tibi Domine.
In principio ore verbum, et verbum ere tabu Deum, et Deus ere verbum, hoc erat in principio ago Deum, omni principum factus sunt, et sinus factum est nihil, quo factum est. In ipso vita erat luz omnium, et luz in terra est luce, et tenebrae non comprehendere. Quid homo nisus ut eque nomen erat Ioannes, si veniti testimonium, ut testimonium perdit lumen, et donis perdit brillum. Non erit eri lux, erat testimonium perdit lumen, erat lux vere, quae lumina domine homine vietem et comunum. Figuru erat murus principum factus est, murus non comionum, et propri veniti sum non luciferum. Quod quod erat luciferum, et erat est superstati filios et fiei, et qui credit nomine eius, qui nomis agit vinibus, ne presentati carnis, ne presentati viris, et eternati sum. Et verbum carnum factum est. Abitabili nobis et vinimus glorium in gloriam quas unigenite et patria per gratia veritatis. Deo
gratias.
God save Elizabeth our Queen, and
graciously hear us when we call upon thee.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray for thy servant Elizabeth, our Queen, upon whom thy mercy has laid the government of this kingdom. May she be given still greater measure of every virtue, thus worthily adorned when she turn aside from all wickedness. May she overcome her enemies, and with her consort and the royal family, may she come at last in grace to thee, the way, the truth,